So good afternoon to everyone. My AV is working. Okay, thank you, Abhishek. It's action. So yesterday we were discussing about the reliability. So the main thing is the spinning reserve is the major thing which is required to meet the load demand during random failures. Hope random failures may be anything. It may be accident or it may be due to faults or etc. Understood. Hope you have got some information about the latest incident that has happened in oil and gas power plant near Elanka from Govindapasa. So because of this random failures or random accidents or random faults that are occurring on a power system, so to supply the power continuously is not assured by the power system operator. However, you can minimize that is load shedding. We have to do load shedding. That's what I explained. So this load shedding time, you can minimize it. We cannot eliminate it completely. So we cannot provide, that is, we means the power system engineers cannot provide the power continuously. Understood? So I explained various reasons. So the one thing is spinning reserve. I take, so a simplified treatment of the reliability calculation, so we have to carry out. So that one is carried out by using the alternate periods of operation and repair. So, okay. So this is the periods I have shown it. So it is a two-state model. So one is downstate or upstate. So downstate is treated as zero level. Upstate is treated as one level. Understood? So also I have given example of three-state model also. When you will get a three-state model, when you have a derated generator. So I explained derated generator means the lifespan of that generator might have been over. So still, it may be producing some capacity. Suppose if it is 100 megawatt rating, it may not be producing 100 megawatt. It may be producing say 70 or 80 megawatts. But still, we will be using that generator. So it is a derated generation. So then we will have derated time. We will have, that is another state. However, here we will be dealing it with only two state model. So in that one, downstate, upstate argument. So obviously, you will have the corresponding timings, isn't it? So that means during on time, which is the time which is known as during on time, is known as uptime. It is denoted by T1 up. And during the failure, so it drops down and it will take some time for maintenance or to repair that generator. Again, it will be put into operation. So we are having T1 up, T2 up, T3 up. So therefore, what is the total time taken is T1 plus T2 plus T3. This is the total duration. And total duration is time we have taken it here. And obviously this one is during downtime, it is represented by T1 down, T2 down, T3 down. So this is what I have explained it. And you obviously will have alternate periods of operation and repair. And obviously the uptime will be more than the downtime. Then only we can supply a quality of power, that is reliable power. Understood? So you should not take downtime more than your uptime. Whenever a fault occurs or maintenance purpose, you have to resume the power back to the service within short period. Okay, this is what I said. The length of individual operating and repair periods are random phenomenon. So operating time will be longer than your failure rate. So in such cases, the mean time to failure. I said, we have discussed that the unit has been operating for a long time. The random phenomenon can be described by the following parameters. You see this one? This is a statement I made it. A unit has been operating for a long time. But when a random phenomenon may occur on this system or on this unit. So this random phenomenon which is happening on this unit is described by some parameters. So those parameters I will be giving it here. So that is, one is mean of time. Mean of time. That is nothing but your mean time to failure. Mean time to failure. Here we are having it. So that is known as your mean of time. So that is given by T up. That is total period. T up means it is the total period in which the unit is in operational. That means what T up is equal to? You have to add up all the T ups time. You have to add all the T ups time in this waveform. So you have to add T1 up plus T2 up plus T3 up plus etc. You have to add up this one over a full cycle. Over a full cycle. Maybe it is full cycle maybe for a day, or maybe you are taking for a 5 days, 10 days, 1 month. So depending on the problem definition. Okay, so over a cycle, we have to take number of cycles for a given period of time. So you have to add up all this T1, T2, T3. So this 1, 2, 3, I'll be using it as a sum indication here. You can see this here. That's why I use summation of Tj, where j is varied from 1, 2, 3, etc. Understood? So all these Tj ups, you have to add up, you have to sum up over a period of cycle. That is, how many cycles are there over a period of time? So number of cycles. Understood? So you may be having 4 cycles over a given period of time. That is number of cycles, 4 cycles. That means which one? 4 up cycles will be there. That is, operating cycles will be there over a given period of time. So that is number of cycles over a given period of time that you have to consider. So this is how it is defined. Mean up time, that is nothing but average up time, is equal to, you have to sum up all the up times divided by number of cycle. Similarly, you have to come out with mean time to repair. Mean time to repair, or mean downtime, that is average downtime. So what you are going to do, once again, average downtime. So you have to add up all the down timings. You have to add up all the down timings. So what are the down times? T1 down, T2 down, T3 down, etc. So again here, you have to add Tj only, or some other suffix if you want, you can take it. So j is varied from 1, 2, 3, etc. So you have to sum up that one. You can see here, only thing is here it is up, here it is down. That's all. The ratio is same. So sum, you have to add up all the down times over a period of time. You check how many cycles are there. So divide that one by number of cycles over a period of time, or over a given period of time. This is your mean down time, or mean time to repair. This is known as T down. Mean time to failure is T up. That is mean up time. So which is given by this equation. Hope you understood. All the up times you have to add divided by number of cycles. And all the down times you have to add up and divided by number of cycles is your total time down, down period, total down period over a given period. Suppose over a period of 24 hours. So what is T down? Or over a period of 1 month, or over a period of 1 year. So what is the down time? So depending on the history of that operation of that particular unit, you are going to find out these things. That is T up down and D T down time. Is it clear? So mean up time, mean down time. These are the things you are getting it. So what is the mean cycle time? That is average cycle time, so total one. So total period is equal to average is equal to, so T up plus T down. Understood? So this is T up plus T down is your mean cycle time. So this is what T up and T down we got for two state model. We got it for two state model. So Suppose if it is three state, again you will be having another parameter here. So that is t d rating you will be getting it. So here, so there also you have to add up all the d rated periods and divided by number of cycles. Third state, this is for your information, I am giving the external lens here. So similarly, mean cycle time is equal to t up plus t down plus t d rating. You know what is d rated generated, I told that one. So this is what, how it will go. Even four state model also it is there. Okay. So this is mean cycle time, we are having it. So three state, four state model also will be having it. Okay, from this one, we are going to derive some reliability indices. Usually there are so many reliability indices are there, which has been derived by the researchers. So different reliability indices, they will be developing and using it to determine the quality of the power supply, that means what, reliability of the power supply. So one such, only one basic thing I will be giving it, some of the reliability thing, inverse of the times which we had defined earlier, we are going to take. That is inverse of this t up time, inverse of this t down time. So we'll be taking it and we'll be assigning it here with some parameters. So you can see here. Can you hear? Okay. So this is the thing we are going to see, inverse of this time. So inverse of your uptime is your failure rate, which is indicated by lambda. So what is the failure rate for two state model, which is denoted by lambda? It is nothing but inverse of your uptime. Understood? T up. Similarly, inverse of your downtime. Inverse of your downtime, that is known as repair rate. That is known as repair rate, which is indicated by mu. Very good. Okay, so just let me complete it. So failure and repair rates are estimated from the past data, that is the history data. The failure rates are affected by preventive maintenance. So by regular maintenance, you can prevent these failure rates. And the repair rates are sensitive to size, composition and skill of repair teams. Understood? These repair rates, suppose if you don't have skilled laborers or skilled employees, so they will take more time. So therefore, this repair rates depends on the size of the machine and the composition and skill of repair teams. Understood? So these are the parameters you should remember, lambda and mu. So hope you understood this one. So I'm having some meeting now. So this completes your reliability thing here. So let us stop today's class. So I'm having some meeting here called by principal. So I'll be continuing it this one in the next class. Thank you, Anurag.